Okay, see here. So the meaning of lean Six Sigma, in the sense it is nothing. In the recent years, what happened? We have a Six Sigma system. So we try to integrate this Six Sigma system with manufacturing. So here, what is the additional terminology we added? To the Six Sigma, we have added system with manufacturing. We aligned with the manufacturing. This is what the main focus is on. So, in under Six Sigma, we talked about how exactly the Sigma works, that is being developed by the Motorola. To that, we have additionally given the manufacturing alignment. So this manufacturing alignment is added to the Six Sigma, then we called as the lean manufacturing or the lean production. We called with the term lean production or lean manufacturing. So when we try to define what is meant by lean production, or we can say lean manufacturing. So it's nothing but it's a systematic approach. Where it identifies, it's a systematic approach which try to identify the identifies and eliminates the waste. Identifies the waste and at the same time eliminates the waste through continuous improvement. It's a continuous improvement. It is a continuous process. With continuous improvements by flowing the product as per the customer demand. It is a continuous process as per the customer demand. So let's once again let me define it. It is nothing but it's a systematic approach which identifies the waste and eliminates the waste through continuous improvement by flowing the product as per the customer demand. This is what the main focus is on in lean production or lean manufacturing. The lean corresponds to nothing but no waste, where the waste refers to anything that is added to the cost of the product, but not to the value of the product. We consider the cost of the product, not the value of the product. Cost of the product, not the value of the product. This is what we call it as no waste. Means no waste. So in this we... There exist three types of works in any process. There are three types of works. First one, value added. Second one, non-value added. Third one, waste. Value added, non-value added, and waste. In value added services, like you can relate or map with corresponding value added services of even the cell phone services or the mobile services, value added. The process, they produce value for the customer and for which the customer ready to pay. Means it is essential to meet the requirements. For example, you wanted to have additional ringtones than a normal ringtone. If you want to listen a song, it is nothing but a value added service. Means it has some value. The customer ready to pay for that. Those are called as value-added services. When we talk about non-value-added services, they are not essentially needed to produce a value for the customer, but are required for other reasons. Like, for example, if you register in the bank, so they are going to send you some messages. That is what the additional service provided. So, such as fulfilling the company mandates, legal requirements and regulatory requirements. These are called as non-value, which is added, non-value. So value added services where the customer pay, non value added services where there is no value need to produce, there is no need to need not produce a value for the customer, but are required for the other reasons. Then next, when we talk about the waste, the process steps produce no value for the customer, but consumes some resources. That is what we call it as a resource. They have no value, but they consume resources. They have no value, but they consume resources. That is what we generally call it as a waste. What do you call a waste at home? It is there, the product is there, the item is there, but is not in use, but it is occupying the space. For example, you take a bottle, a cool drink bottle. Once you use it, then you are not going to use. So you will throw it away. That is what we consider as a waste. So here, in case of a lean production, there are 8 types of waste they are defined. There are 8 types of waste they defined. Identified. So first one, defective products. It is considered as a waste. Actually, they have mentioned 8 types, but the thing we get, it's only 7 we are getting. So because I cannot add on my own anything required, so might be there are 7 types. So let's not discuss about that. So might be 7 types. Okay, where first of all, defects. The total and money wasted for determining mistakes and fixing the defects. This is what considered as a defects. The second one, overproduction. It is not waste, it is overproduction. So under overproduction, production more than what is needed, it is called as overproduction. The next, what is meant by waiting? Work delayed due to waiting machines, people and material. That is what we consider as waiting. Transportation, time and efforts involved in movement of materials, products, information and people, transformation. The next, motion. Where unnecessary work handoffs or transfer. Unnecessary hands off or transfer. The next, extra processing. Doing more work on improving the quality than needed. That is what we call it as extra processing. The next, inventory. Holding additional material or the resources that are not required. That is what we consider them as waste. Defects, overproduction, waiting, transportation, motion, extra processing, and inventory. So then when we talk about this, when we talk about the Lean Six Sigma, then how we can discuss the success can be increased, the success factors that can be increased with the Six Sigma. So how can we make an improvement? So under this Six Sigma, it's a major business initiative, need to be nurtured, enabled by, and maintained on a regular basis to increase the success impact. So this must be implemented in the business initiatives. So it needs to be nurtured. It needs to be enabled. And it must be maintained on a regular basis, not as a random, on a regular basis. Once we use this on a regular basis, we try to find some improvement in the business operations. The Six Sigma is not at all, not the end all be all. It is simply a set of process tools which could never suggest that a company's performance solely. So in that we need to find there are Six Sigma enablers. So here we talk about Six Sigma enablers. One is leadership commitment. Second one, change in the culture. Next, change in the attitude. Then next, challenging standards, customer flows, and continuous improvement. Then let us talk about each and every point. Let's talk about each and every one. First one, leadership commitment. So the most successful firm is a total commitment from the top management and the senior leadership. That is where the leadership commitment comes from, the top management. When the top management takes initiation in employing the Six Sigma process, then we could definitely find a change in the next change in culture. It focuses on predetermined, tangible, and time-bound objectives of business. Predetermined, tangible, and time-bound objectives. Time-bound objectives of business. The culture that is changed due to the changes in the perspective of delivering the tangible or positive results. The next one is changing in attitudes. There is a complete change in the attitudes of the management and organizational employees. Attitude of management and organizational employees, where all the members have needs a change themselves. They need to change themselves and should focus on attainment of the final objective. How they achieve or attain the final objectives. The final objectives of the organization. The next one, how challenging standards. The Six Sigma develops challenging standards which are complicated but were effective. Which are complicated. Yes, definitely you can say it is a complicated process. But it is a very effective. Very effective in nature in attaining the firm's organizational performance. The next, customer flows. The main here, the measure of process which helps in attaining the requirements of the customers too. So how the customers requirements are met. The requirements are met. That is the main. The next one, continuous improvement. Six Sigma consolidates means regular work where we are trying to implement. It is not as a random process, it has a continuous process by satisfying the continuous improvement. Though these need to be looked into, each and every aspect is carefully being watched, monitored for improvements in the customer satisfaction, satisfying the customers. So it must be a improvement and it must be a continuous process. That's what we consider in continuous improvement. Then in some cases we need to talk about what is the basic difference between Six Sigma and balanced scorecard. There might be chances where they can ask what is the basic difference between Six Sigma versus balanced scorecard. And when we talk about Six Sigma, there is a high quality of products or services are being used. It possesses, the Six Sigma possesses high quality of products or services, which makes the probability of getting defective products very less. Whereas the balanced scorecard relates to strategic goals and objectives. It is not pure product oriented, but they are how the strategic goals and business objectives are being achieved. In case of a Six Sigma, they go with the problem solving methodology, which helps in reducing the defects and its related costs. Whereas in case of problem solving methodology, reduce the defects. It helps to reduce defects and related costs, reduce related costs. And here in case of balanced scorecard, it is purely focused on balancing the organizational goals, strategic goals. It focuses towards vision and values. Vision and values. The next, the process management. The Six Sigma considers process management improvement, measurement, as a daily activity, not as a random activity, as a daily activity. It considered as a daily activity, not as a random activity. Whereas in case of balanced scorecard, the strategic management system measures, the system measures. Management, it considered as strategic management as a system measure. The next one, in Six Sigma process, the defects are free goods. Defects of free goods. Means only, not only the products, not only produces defective free goods, but they try to reinvent them. Helps to reinvent them or re-innovate them. Means whenever it is needed, it is going to reinvent or re-innovate the product when it is considered under Six Sigma. Whereas a balanced scorecard identifies the measurements, highlights the target of for each and every measure. Means it not only identifies the measurements, but it also highlights the targets of each measure. The next one, when we talk about, it brings standards of performance. The Six Sigma gets the standards of improvement and in the performance. Standards of improvement in the performance. The next one, the balanced scorecard will try to identify the key management processes. The key management, identification of key management processes such as organizational vision, the organizational strategy, organizational plan, and feedback. They are taken care by the balanced scorecard. When we talk about critical to quality, CTQ. So Six Sigma uses CTQ aspect, which is the most critical from the customer's point of view. CTQ is the most important. Whereas the balanced scorecard purely focuses on the elements such as the organizationals, internal operations, strategy goals, and customers. Then the last point. So it solves customer problems effectively. The Six Sigma solves because it is a pure oriented towards, the satisfaction of the customer. So when the customer is satisfied, so we have the business improvements, what they think in such a way. So whereas in case of balanced scorecard, it towards balancing the strategic organization. It only works towards the organizational balancing. So that's what we need to consider in Six Sigma versus balanced scorecard. So these are the two major important tools in business performance management. Okay, so how the Sigma, success of Sigma is can be enabled, and what is meant by Lean Six Sigma. In the morning session, we talked about what is the different strategies, BPM methodologies. Those are widely used, BSC and Six Sigma, and how we try to align the strategies and actions. The next, we talked about DMAIC, that is definition, measure, analysis, improve and control. Then next, we now just now discussed about what is meant by Lean Sigma, Six Sigma, and how it is being used in the manufacturing. And then next, what is the, how can we improve the success of Six Sigma? So we call it as enablers. The next, what is the difference between Six Sigma and the balanced scorecard? Let me stop the video.